Hello everyone, Danas here with ActionVFX. So Scott Pilgrim vs. the World is one of my favorite films, and in it there is an effect that I've always wanted to do, which is the eye glowing, smoking effects that the character Todd Ingram has in the movie. So we are going to recreate that in After Effects with some few modifications of our own, such as using ActionVFX Secret Smoke Collection to do the blowing smoke, and then we want to add a little bit of texture to the glow instead of just a solid white color like in the movie. Before we start, don't forget to click that subscribe button so you don't miss out on more cool tutorials like this one. Anyway, let's get started. Okay, so this is our shot. The first thing we are going to do is, of course, we want to track my eyes. And we are going to do that using Mocha. You can use Mocha AE, but here I am using Mocha Pro. Now, in Mocha, we don't want to track my eyeballs because here you can see that we have my pupil twitching around and that will mess around with the track. Not only that, we have the goggles covering my eyes and also the shadows, and that will mess around with the track also. So what I want to do, we want to go to a frame where we have a clear uninterrupted look of the eye, and then we want to create a shape surrounding my eye socket so we don't have to worry about the pupil, and then we are going to track that forward. Okay, so we have a clear track forward, and then for the track backwards, we are going to do that manually. So let's click on Show Planar Surface, and here we have a corner pin representation of our track. And then on the panel here, let's check Manual Tracking. And then we are going to move a few frames backwards, and let's move our track. Perfect. Now let's add more keyframes, and then let's rename this layer, Tracker Left Eye, and then we're going to disable it. And then we are going to create another mask. This time, we are going to create the shape of my eyeball. And then let's parent or link this mask shape to the tracker that we just made. And now we have our shape here following the movement. So then what we can do is to scrub through the timeline and adjust the shape of our mask to fit with my eyeball. So next we are going to do the exact same thing again, but to the other eye. And perfect. Now we are going to close Mocha and save. And now we are in After Effects. Let's create two null objects, one for each left and right eye. And then we're gonna go to our plate that has the Mocha on it, click create track data. And then let's select the tracker for the left eye. And then on the export option, we're going to select transform. And then we are going to export it to the left eye null. And then let's do the same thing to the right eye. Okay, so now the nulls are following. Let's disable the scale and rotations animation for the nulls. After that, we're going to create the first pass of our eye glow, which is the glint. There are many ways to do this, but this is my favorite and most easiest method that I have done several times before. So what you want to do is to grab a lens flare asset. This one is from our icon lens flare collection. And then we are going to find a frame that we like and then freeze frame it. And then we are going to create a mask because we only want the small part of the flare. And then let's feather it out and then change the blending mode to add. And then we want to position it to the middle of our eyeball. And then we are going to parent our flare here to the respective null. And great. Next, we want to animate the opacity so our flare here fades out when the eyes is closed. And then we're going to hold Alt and click on the stopwatch of the opacity. And then we are going to make this flare flicker. So type in wiggle 8,20, and there we go. So now every 1 second, the opacity will change 8 times in the unit of 20. And then let's color this, let's get a tint and set the white color to something like a yellowish color. Now let's duplicate our flare and move it to the other eye, and let's change it up a bit and then redirect the parent to the null for the other eye, and we have our first pass of the glow. Okay, next we are going to add an overall glow to the eyeball. So let's duplicate our plate that has the Mocha on it, and we are going to put it on top and rename it eyeballs. And then we're gonna go to Mocha, and in matte, we're gonna create AE mask. So now if we solo this, we have created a mask based on the shapes that we have made earlier. So let's feather it a bit. Usually to make the energy glow, we would just fill this with a solid color and call it a day. But that would result in a very flat looking eyeball. And I want to retain a little bit of texture that we have on the original eye to give an impression that it is still a three-dimensional eyeball. So, first I want to add invert, and now we have the color of our eyeball is inverted. And then I'm going to add tint, and for the white, I'm going to select like a yellow-orangish color. And then I'm going to add curve, and let's pull down the black levels, and increase the white level a little bit. And then let's add glow. And then on threshold, I'm going to set it to 80, and radius to 7, and glow intensity to 0.5. And then let's set the glow color to A and B colors. And for the color B, let's set it to something like yellow-orange. And then let's duplicate the glow, and then reduce the threshold to 4.5, and increase the radius to 50. Okay, great. Now let's change our layer mode to overlay. And there we go. Again, let's bring our opacity, and we want to make sure to have this effects fade off when my eyes are covered. Next, we're going to do the most fun part, which is the smoke coming out of my eyeballs. So let's grab a cigarette smoke element here and parent it to the eye null. Awesome. So here we can see what we have to do to the smoke, which is first, it's currently moving too slow. So let's right click and time stretch it to 50%. And then I want to have this smoke to start or ignite just when my eyes are open. And to do that, we could use the ignition part that we have on the smoke, like the smoke number 5 here, but maybe we don't like the shape of the smoke at the time of this ignition. So what we want to do is we want to time our own smoke ignition based on the shape that we like. So here if we see on our footage, notice that the smoke is coming out in several puffs. So what we want to do is we want to search a puff that we like, and then we want to set that as the start of our ignition. So let's trim out the beginning, and let's move it to when my eyes are opening, and then we want to create a mask around that puff, and then manually animate the mask as the puff grow. And there we go, a very simple cheat on how to create your own smoke ignition. So now let's add another smoke to the other eye and repeat the same process. Okay, so this is the main smoke that is coming out directly from the eyeballs. Next, I want to add another layer of smoke to work as some sort of atmospheric clumps that has been built up inside of the goggles. So let's duplicate the smoke that we have, delete the mask, and let's find a different frame where we have the smoke more clumped together. And then we are going to mask around that, and then animate the mask again as the smoke grows, and then let's do the same to the other eye, and perfect. So next what we want to do is we want to color correct our smoke here. But instead of giving a straight up color correction, I want the smoke to have a little bit of gradient from the lighting. Especially we have like a blue moonlight from the right side of our shot. So we want to pre-compose our smoke, but before we do, let's duplicate our nulls and then redirect the parents of our smoke to that duplicated nulls. And then let's pre-compose our smoke and the duplicate nulls together. Go inside the pre-comp, and then I want to add tint to the smoke. And then on the white color, I want to set a bit of yellow color to make it look like the smoke is primarily being lit by the eye glow. And then let's duplicate the tint to all the other smoke. And then let's create an adjustment layer. And then add another tint and set it to light blue. And then let's create a mask on the right side here and feather it out. So now it's looking like there is a blue light hitting our smoke from the right side. Perfect. Now, let's go back to the main composition, and let's select the smoke pre-comp and put it below all the eyeball layers so the edge of the smoke blends more with the eye. And then we are going to add curve, and here, just when my eyes are still covered by the shadow, we want to darken it out. And then add keyframe, and then we want to move to where the goggles is fully off, and let's brighten up the color back to normal. Great. And then we want to animate the opacity as well to make the smoke fade in. And there we go. And then let's add a Gaussian blur to blur out our smoke a little bit so it's not too sharp. And then let's create a shadow. So let's duplicate our pre-comp here. And then on the bottom one, let's name it shadow. And then let's nudge it to the side. And then we want to delete all of the effects on the duplicate and replace it with fill layer. And we want to set it to black. And then we are going to add fast blur and blur it out. And then let's lower down the opacity. Okay, awesome. So we have tackled the big stuff. Now let's add a little bit more to finish things up. Let's create an adjustment layer, put it below everything, but just above the plate. And then we want to add curve, and let's punch up our middle tone here. And then also let's punch up the red and the green. Next, I want to create masks around my eyes and feather it up. So it's looking like there is an energy from my eyes that is seeping through the skin of my skull. And then I want to animate the mask to follow the eyes. And awesome. So for the final part is, of course, we need to mask out my goggles and my hands here that are covering our elements at the beginning. So here is the mask layer of my goggles and my hands. I'm not showing you in detail on how I did the masking process because basically you can use anything. You can use roto brush, you can mask it manually. However, for this, I did use Mocha to mask it, and the process is basically the same as the way I generated the mask for the eyeballs. So what I did is I tracked some parts of the goggles, which is the circle part of the lens, and then used that track data to parent a more elaborate mask that fits the shapes of the goggles. And then I bring that mask to After Effects just like before, and then I increase some feather on the masks to make them blend better with the elements. One thing to keep in mind is to trim out this mask layer after the goggles is on my head, so the mask doesn't clip the smoke when it reaches that height. And that was our shot. That was the tutorial on creating this eye burning, smoking, glowing effects inspired by the movie Scott Pilgrim vs. the World. Once again, if you want to purchase the assets that I used in this tutorial, you can check out our website at actionvfx.com. At ActionVFX, we provide high quality VFX assets for your VFX needs. We have fire, explosions, energy, and many, many others. You can also sign up for our ActionVFX subscription starting at the low cost of $14.99 a month. This is the most affordable way to access our library, and you can cancel anytime, no contract. Thank you so much for watching. Let us know in the comment section below what kind of tutorials that you'd like to see next. And see you next time. Bye-bye.